everyone, it's Moose, and thank you so much for joining me back here. Today we are not doing a book video. I wanted to introduce you to my son. So if you've been watching me here recently, you would know that I have been pregnant, obviously, since I'm holding a baby now. Our little boy decided to come early and come spend about an extra week and a half with us. So this is Samuel. He's nice and awake right now. He just ate breakfast. And I think he's trying to poop. So, he's nice and awake right now. But he likes to be burped. Like, even if he doesn't need to burp, he just likes to lay like this. So, Samuel was born on March 27th at 1:56 a.m. He was an early, early baby in the morning. Oh, man, bud. His due date was April 7th, and today, when I'm recording this, is April 4th, and he is 1 week and 1 day old, so he came a little bit early, which I am very thankful for. It's just an extra week that I get to spend with him. He's already lifting his head a little bit, as you can see. He likes to move around and look around. He's a big wiggle worm. When he was born, he was 8 pounds, 3 ounces, and 21 inches long. At his last appointment, last Tuesday, today is Saturday, he weighed 7'11", so he lost a little bit of weight, but not too much. He's still in the good range, and I think he's starting to gain it back. He's been eating a lot more in the past couple days. As far as how everything went, everything was great. I don't know, textbook labor, man. It was awesome. I'm very blessed. Didn't have any complications throughout pregnancy. Didn't really have any complications during labor either. I had a fever. But that was about it. They think it was because I was dehydrated when I got to the hospital. So other than that, everything went smoothly. I tore twice, but they were just first degree tears, and they kind of expect first time moms to tear anyways. So it wasn't that big of a deal. Like I say, Sam is healthy. He's talking to me. The dogs are very different. They're not what I expected to be with him. Underbite. Oh, bless you, bud. Underbite, which is our tiny dog that you see in vlogs all the time, loves him. She loves to try to swaddle him and cover him up and stuff like that. Whereas Maggie, who is our very affectionate and jealous puppy who wants attention all the time, doesn't really want anything to do with him. She's not hostile or aggressive or anything. She's just not taking any interest in him, which really shocked me. I expected her to be the one to want to be near him and nuzzle him and stuff like that. But so far, no, that's okay though. We're still kind of trying to figure each other out. You know, he's been completely just chilling for the last 9 months. So now he's learning how to poop, and he's learning how to eat and breathe and look around. So he's really, his world has been turned upside down. So he's trying to figure everything out. We're trying to figure him out, but it's going really well. The biggest challenge has definitely been breastfeeding. I have dealt with babies since I was very young. I have older brothers who are much older than I am, by about like 8 years. And so one of my brothers has 3 daughters, and I grew up, you know, with babies in my family. So the baby part I'm not too worried about, and it hasn't really been that bad. Breastfeeding is a completely new experience for me, and it's honestly a lot harder than I thought it would be. It's just been, I think we finally have found something that works for us, but it has been a little bit of a challenge just figuring out what works for him, because they'll tell you stuff in the hospital, which are good kind of standard rules, but I found that some of them don't work for him. He just gets too fussy and aggravated. So like certain latches and holds and stuff like that. They teach you in the hospital before you leave to hold him chest to chest. So you hold him sideways and let him eat that way. And he does not like that. He's fine with it once he gets latched on, if I bring him up and hold him kind of like this. But as far as actually getting him to start eating, he prefers to just lay on my lap and me lay over him. That way he can't really get away from the boob. He's very handsy, so he's constantly trying to like push me away and stuff like that whenever we're first getting latched on. So, but I think we finally found something that works. He decided he wanted to eat, so. But yeah, it's getting easier. We're figuring it out. He eats a lot. The first little bit was a little difficult just because I think he has something wrong with his latch. He's still eating and he's gulping, and so he's getting food and he's pooping a lot. So I know he's hydrated and fed, but it hurts sometimes, especially at the beginning. My nipples were so sore and cracked, and I was getting blisters on them. So that was definitely difficult, and I didn't really know what to do. Like I say, I've never done this before, but it has gotten better. I feel like I know this is weird to say and talk about, but my nipples are getting kind of calloused over, so it's a lot easier now. So yeah, I think that's about it. I just wanted to introduce you to my baby, who I have been waiting on for so long, it feels like. He's perfect. Absolutely perfect. I'm so in love with him. I mean, everybody else is talking about how much hair he has. I think that's about it, though. I just wanted to update you guys, tell you how it went. I'm so blessed. I'm so thankful. I'm so happy. Ethan has been great. Ethan has time off right now from work, so he's been home to help me. He's currently out running right now, working out, but it's been awesome. He's been helping me with housework and, you know, taking care of me and the baby. Absolutely awesome. So yeah, I just thought I'd update you guys. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed meeting my son. He is so precious, and expect to see him in more videos soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. You are awesome. I'm thankful for you, and we'll meet back here next time. See ya!